That meeting with Chloe certainly got Pete thinking. He can't quite believe he's allowed himself to be this dominated by a wealthy older woman.
Not too proud to drink a wine or indeed eat a Bombay mix, though, is he, Colin?
No, indeed.
Here they are. My loyal wife and her latest bit of rough.
You're drunk.
Tell me, Rosalind, what do you prefer about Pete's cock to my cock?
Do you two ever just talk about the weather?
No, it's not just his cock I prefer, Duncan.
So, Pete, tell me, do you enjoy fucking my wife?
Can we please just stop using the proper word for things?
Why? You are fucking her with your cock, aren't you?
Yeah, but why can't we just say, how's your father and Willie?
You little prick.
If you wanted me, Duncan, you should have done something about it 20 years ago when you were fucking everything in your office. This ship sailed a long time ago.
Yes, and with the ferry doors wide open.
Perhaps you'd like to stay and watch while Pete gives me a tit fuck.
Oh, I didn't agree to that.
Oh, don't worry about him. He makes a lot of noise, but he can't do anything anymore, can you?
You bitch.
Looks like Pete's had enough. He's got to get out of this degenerate relationship and maybe, just maybe, he'll have a chance to get back with the pure and wholesome Chloe.
She was certainly up for it.
Chucking a woman, new territory for Pete. He's always been the one being chucked. With little to go on, he'll be relying heavily on his TV viewing.
Roz, we need to talk.
Kicking off with neighbours.
That sounds ominous.
This situation, it isn't healthy for either of us.
EastEnders.
Don't get me wrong, I love all the stuff you've given me.
Oh, that's not so good, it was his own.
It's just, I feel like my identity's being stifled.
Holby City.
This wouldn't have anything to do with that girl this afternoon, would it? She's not a lesbian, is she?
Hollyoaks. I wonder when that might make an appearance.
No. Anyway, that's got nothing to do with it. Because I think we both know that things haven't been right for a while, and I think if we get out now, then we can finish it before either of us really hurts the other one.
It's the jackpot!
Then there's nothing more to be said. Thank you for everything, Peter.
Oh. Well, Pete's unexpected display of moral fortitude paying big dividends as he's now going out once again with the lovely Chloe.
Aye, and it must be love because completely unprompted he's taken her round to visit his parents.
Well, he's a glutton for punishment.
Aye, it'd be simpler to stick his knackers in a light socket, Colin.
Terry.
All right. Where's Ros?
She's not coming.
Oh, dear. I was really looking forward to seeing her. She's not ill, is she?
No. Actually, Mum, we broke up.
Oh, wonderful.
Hello.
This is Chloe.
Oh, hello, dear.
Hello.
Hello, I'm Frank.
Hi. I like your shirt.
Oh, thank you.
Quick question. Where would you say is the coldest place in Britain?
I don't know. Somewhere in Scotland?
No, it's actually just down the road in Rickmansworth.
Really?
So now we join Pete on his birthday and we can track him here on his way back from the pub. He's made up with his mates and things seem to be going from strength to strength with the lovely Chloe.
Whose birthday present for him was a 2 quid friendship bracelet from Camden Market.
If he was still with Roz, it might have been a Rolex.
Oh, this is fantastic, Ollie. You remembered me.
Oh, that's the least we could do. We felt a bit bad about the trip, so.
I've had to keep it a secret for days. I've been bursting, man, bursting.
I'll get some beers.
Well, I'll give you a hand.
Oh, I'll have a quick clean out of the traps and then rustle us up some food. Oh, thanks, mate. That's so nice of you. thanks so much for not bringing Anna as well. Like, it's just so much nicer without her, isn't it? She told me a really weird story the other day, right? So when she's young, yeah, her breasts were really slow to develop. And obviously all the girls at school hated her, obviously. And when she was getting changed, they got a load of boys to come in. All the boys called her Pancake Tits. Who's in the cake?
You shit!
Oh, hello, Anna. I wondered where you were.
Oh, you should have waited.
Come on, Rob. We're leaving.
Oh, okay.
Who wants to see a mouse? Chloe, you remember Anna.
Hiya. Hi. And actually, I'm a 34B.
Peter, I need you. I miss your cock.
Pete?
It's only when I'm fucking you that I feel alive.
You've been fucking your Auntie Roz.
Yeah, there's no good way to answer that question.
No, Chloe! Chloe!
Peter, I've taken some pills.
I'll call an ambulance.
And that is it. What was all set to be the perfect end to a birthday evening now looks like it's going to be spent in the casualty department of Chase Farm Hospital, listening to a middle-aged woman having her stomach pumped.
Oh, well, we've all been there, Colin.
Well, not all of us, but then not all of us have played top-flight football.
My highlight was Pete's new hairdo.
No contest for me. Yeah.
Well, that's enough of that.